So in introductory part of packing, what was given? It was given that do you like going to on trips? So all the things were discussed yesterday. So in packing, there are basically three main characters. Which are three main characters are there? And who was third one? And this chapter is written by whom? Jerome K. So he has written the chapter and he is also a part of the chapter. So what can be he consider? He can be considered narrator. So when you will be going through the whole chapter, you will come to know that narrator words come so many times, because this chapter is narrated by narrator and he is also a part of that chapter, and he is telling, you can say, biography, that actually what happened when three friends, they plan to go for a trip, and along with these three friends there is a fourth character. You will be considering that character. What is that? It is Montmorency. And he is what? He is a dog. Okay. So whole of the chapter is full of humor. Whole of the chapter is full with lots of funny incident that you people will enjoy all these incident. Basically, what is the theme of this chapter? To make you laugh. Okay. And to laugh on the silly episode, silly incident, which were, you can say, carried by these three friends. Because one of the friend, he thinks that he is very much superior. Second thinks, yes, no, I don't want to do any work. I want to put all my duty on next one. He is kind of lazy person. But nobody is proficient. Nobody is perfect. Okay. Everybody is there with all their flaws. Everybody is there with all their negative and positive points. So Sonali ma'am has taken my period yesterday. Up to which passage you have? Up to ninth you have done. Okay. So I'm going to carry on from ninth passage, because in ninth passage there is an incident of packing eatables. So what should be that common sense should be used, and when eatables are to be packed? So the very soft things like tomatoes, etc., should be they packed at the bottom? No, they should be always kept at top. It happens in your daily life also. You can check your. Last two, Jaskirat and Kavarnur. Second last, you can also shift. You listen only. Sit down. So what happened? See, the very hard things, they are kept at the bottom. You can check in your fridge also when your mother keeps vegetables, veggies, etc. in fridge. So does she keep tomato at last and heavy pumpkin at the top? Does it happen? No. Heavy things are kept at the bottom and soft things are kept at the top, so that these soft things should not be squashed. Okay. So so from ninth paragraph it is given that it was a turn of George. Okay. And he stepped on butter. Okay. So when there was a butter on the floor, he stepped on that butter because it was so slippery, and he sat on the edge of the table and everybody was looking at him. It really irritated him anything more than anything, because he was feeling nervous also and he was feeling excited also, because they were stepping on things. Okay. And they were putting all the things behind them. When all the things were kept behind them, so they were not able to find out any of the thing. So what can be this said? It can be mismanagement, chaos, Okay, completely kiosk means what is the meaning of kiosk? Yes, it was mess, it was disorder. See, whenever anybody wants to go for any travel, I think they should first of all make a list of all the things. Checklist should be there. They should put a tick mark that these things are to be packed, these are to be kept in separate suitcase, or what to be kept in suitcase, what to be kept in basket, eatables are to be packed separate. So such kind of planning should be done. And such kind of planning can be done only by intelligent person, only by sensible person. But these three friends, they were creating a mess. You can see, because whatever they wanted to carry, they were keeping all the things at one place, behind one of the character. And so many things were steppings. Okay, he was stepping on things. And so many things were kept behind him. And he couldn't find them when they wanted them. So they packed, whenever they did the packing, what did they do? They packed the piles at the bottom and they put heavy things on top, and all the piles, they were completely spoiled. They were completely smashed. Okay, they were completely spoiled. When they were keeping salt, so salt was, you can say, everywhere, it upset everything, and they did not pack butter properly. Okay. So because of only one piece of butter, they created a lot of mess because they slipped on the butter. Okay. So the mess they created, they spoiled so many things. Okay. And after George had got off his slippers, they tried to put it in the kettle. So when they were not able to find out the slippers, from where did they find the slippers? In kettle. In one of the kettle, slippers were found. See how foolish they were in packing. Okay. Yes. No, actually, when he fell down, so his slipper went into the kettle. Earlier, he was not able to find out, but at last he found. And where did he find? He was able to find out that slipper in kettle. Okay. So, such kind of funny incidents were going on, that salt upset everything. Okay, butter also upset everything. And two men, they were, you can say, fighting for butter. Because of that small piece of butter, they created a lot of mess. Okay, George had got it off his slippers. Okay, and they tried to put it and in the kettle, and it was not going on. And what was after that, what was in wouldn't come out. So such kind of mess was there going on. They put it down on a chair. Okay, Harris was sitting on that chair. It stuck to him. Okay, and they were looking here and there where the slipper had gone, and slipper was behind him. It was stuck to him. Okay, so after that, in 11th paragraph, it is given. So he said that he is going to take his oath. Okay, he is going to swear this thing that he is not going to put it down on that chair. Okay, and he was staring at the empty seat. Okay, so for a minute, Harris was looking at all the things, because he was taking a round, and room was looking for it in the room, and they again meeting it. I mean, one person was taking a round, another person was taking a round, and they both were meeting each other. Why so? Because there was a mess in the room. They were not able to find out the material they were supposed to pack. So such kind of mess was going in the room. So George said that very different kind of extraordinary things were going on. So Harry said, no extraordinary, it was mysterious. Okay. So then George also took a round at the back of Harry's, and what he saw, that he saw that he was just roaring, he was just shouting with lots of anger, and where you can say, and they got it off and packed it in the teapot. After finally they got that butter off, and they finally packed that butter in teapot. Okay, so such kind of funny incident was going on. Now after that, again there is one funny incident that is about, you can say, of Montmorency. So do you think that Montmorency was a role to play in this chapter or not? Yes, Montmorency has also a very big role to be played in this chapter, because Montmorency ambition, what was his ambition, what was his desire in life? Okay, Montmorency is the name of a dog. There's no meaning. It is a name of a dog. Okay, so here a trait, quality, or you can say this quality of Montmorency is given. What is that trait of Montmorency given? That if he can swim in anywhere where he can particularly is not wanted and be a perfect nuisance and make people mad and have things thrown at his head, then he feels his day has not been wasted. So very finally, in a very fine way, these lines are depicted about Montmorency. So how it is written, that Montmorency is which kind of a dog? Okay, it means wherever he is not desired, wherever he is not wanted, he would definitely go at that place. So such kind of dog he is, because he could go anywhere, especially where he did not be, where he is not wanted, and he would definitely create a perfect nuisance, and he would definitely make other people mad. Okay, he would make other people mad. Okay, and whatever the things that are thrown at his head, okay, and when people would be feeling fed up with that creature, so he would think now his day is successful, his day is not wasted at all. It means that is his habit, to create nuisance, to create problem in anybody's life. If it is not done, it means his day is not completed. And if all the things are done, it means he thinks now his day is not wasted at all. It means he is which kind of dog, who always creates such kind of problems. Okay. So what is his desire? His desire is that to stumble over him, to curse him. Okay. That are the highest aim and object, okay? And he feels success in doing all the things, in all these accomplishments. It means when he creates problems in others' life, so he thinks that he is successful, because he always creates mess, he always creates problem, okay? And his conceit, it means he feels the pride in doing all the things. Clear? So finally, in 13th paragraph, what is given? In 13th paragraph, it is given, he came and sat down on things just when they were wanted to be packed, and he labored under the fixed belief that whenever Harris or George reached out their hand for anything, it was his cold, damp nose and they wanted. He put his leg into the jam and he worried the teaspoon, and he pretended that the lemons were rats and got into hamper and killed three of them before Harris could land him with the frying pan. So now finally, when there was a task of packing, it was going to be finished, what happened? He came. Who came? Dog. Montmorency. He came and he was sitting on things. Okay, because when they wanted the things, yes, I require this thing, I require this thing, these things to be packed. So when such kind of thing was given, so he was about to pack all the things. So he was doing what? He labored under the fixed belief that whenever Harris or George, they were just reaching out to the things, and whose cold damp nose was there?
Dog.
So it, among all the things, who was found? Whose cold damp nose was found?
No.
Dog. So dog was found there. Okay. and he was putting his leg into
jam.
Okay, and he was worried for the teaspoon. Okay, and he pretended that as lemons were.
Yes.
He wanted to catch all that. He thought that they were not lemons, they were rats. So that's why dog was after those lemons. Okay, so he was got into that hamper, you can say basket, where things were packed. Okay, and he thought that he was about to, he has killed near about three of the rats. Okay, so finally he was landed on the frying pan. Okay, so after that, in next passage, what was told? Harry said, I encouraged him, I did not encourage him. A dog like that doesn't want any encouragement. It is a natural, original sin that is born in him that makes him to do things like that. Okay, so when such kind of allegation was put on Harry's, that Harry's was behind that, Harry's encouraged him. So Harry said, yes, I did not encourage him. Why so? Because such kind of dog, he doesn't require any encouragement. Okay, it is natural. See, it means whatever the things he was doing, that is a natural quality of him. That is a part of his nature, that he creates a mess because nobody has encouraged that dog to do such kind of things. So whatever he was doing, it was his nature. Okay, so near about at 12:50, packing was done. Okay, so finally Harris was sitting on a big hamper. Okay, and he hoped now nothing would be broken. Okay, so George was thinking that if anything was broken, it was broken. And when reflection seemed to be comfort him, he also said he was ready for bed. Okay, so they were ready for bed. It means they finally were ready to go to bed. And Harry's was to sleep with us that night. And that's why they went upstairs, because they did not want to sleep with Harry's. Okay, so they were tossing on their bed. They were not able to sleep properly. Why so? Tossing means they were moving here up left side, then they were moving right side. They were not able to sleep properly. They were moving. Tossing means they were moving. They were taking changing sides. They were changing sides. Okay. Because when Harry's had to sleep with them, he said, do you prefer the inside or outside, Jay? Jay is used for Jerome. Okay. So he said, okay, I wanted to prefer to sit inside. Okay. Harry said, no, it was odd. What was the time? What was the dialect spoken by George? Okay. What time shall I wake you fellows? Because to whom duty was given to wake them up? George was given duty to wake them up. So Harry's gave instruction. Other two characters, because they did not want to sleep with Harry's downstairs. So Harry's was given a duty to wake them up. So Harry's asked that at what time I should wake you up. So Harry said, okay. Sorry, George was given duty to wake them up. So George asked, at what time I should wake you up? So Harry said, near about 7. So he said, no, okay, 6. 6 would be the correct time. Okay. So after that, what final decision they have taken? Okay. They said, okay, wake up at 6:30. So finally, final decision was taken to wake them up at 6:30. Do you think the duty was done properly? Did they wake up at 6:30? Okay. So George did not make any answer. Okay. So they were just going over. They had to be asleep for some time. So they kept their bath tubs where they have to take bath. Okay. So George made no answer, and we found on going over, he had been asleep because George, in morning, he did not get up. He was fast asleep, okay, for some time. And they placed the bath where he could tumble into it, okay, and getting out in the morning, and they went to bed ourselves. So if you really want to know what happened after that incident, you have to go through. There is one of the novel. The name of the novel is Three Men in a Boat. So basically it is a novel. This novel is, whole of the novel is based on story of these three friends. This is only one of the incident. This is only one of the extract. This chapter, extract related to their packing, that has been taken from this novel, and it has been given in your book. Okay, so if you really want to know about more, you should be very much inquisitive. So in your free time, you can get this book issued. If you want, you can take from me also. Even I am also having that novel, Three Men in a Boat, in my cupboard. You can take and you can read. You can read. Because now you are lucky enough, you don't have a novel in your syllabus. Listen, there is a list, but you are not lucky. I don't consider you lucky. Because if you will go through this novel, you will enjoy it. Because earlier in 9th class, it was a part of their syllabus. They were reading whole novel. They were doing all the question answers of novel. Or any kind of incident, any kind of question could be asked in paper. But you have less burden. Because you are a student of this 21st century, online classes are going on, your life has become comfortable. So you don't make your life so comfortable, don't be so lazy and lethargic. You can go through this novel, increase your knowledge, enjoy it. You will enjoy this piece of text. Lethargic, lazy. So now let's discuss question answers. How many characters are there in the narrative? Name them. You don't say three. You have to include dog also. So which are three characters? Harry's, George, Montmorency. So four characters are there. You can write down about the names of these. Four characters only. Okay. Why did the narrator Jerome volunteer to do the packing? Volunteer means without taking anything because of his services. He doesn't want to take anything. So why did the narrator volunteer to do the packing? Yes, Renuka. Okay, any other child? All of you start finding this answer. I can ask. Volunteer means if you are doing any service, any work, so you are not getting anything in place of that, any money or any favor. You are not getting anything in place of that. You are doing with your wish. Willingly you are doing. So why he wanted to do that duty willingly? Are you ready with your answers? Because he wanted to do that packing work because he thought that he was proficient in that. He wanted to, you can say, boast off about his skills of packing. Yes, self-obsessed also. Superiority complex. Yes, very good. Yes, he thought that he was best in the work of packing. Yes, he wants to have a leadership quality. So that's why he took this duty. Okay. Because he thought that it was one of the things that he could do, but others can't. Okay. So he thought that it was one of those things that he knew more about anything else. Okay. So, but when it turned out, because when this duty was actually given to him, was he able to do? No, he was not actually able to. Yes, he was not proficient in that. He was not self-obsessed. He couldn't prove himself in that task that he was really best. Clear? So second answer is clear. Now let's move to question number third. How did George and Harry react to this? Did Jerome like their reaction? So first of all, tell, how did George and Harry react to it?
They agreed.
They agreed or not?
Yes.
They accepted it or not? Yes. They accepted. They accepted Jerome's suggestion. Okay. So after that, what was the scene? George was sitting so relaxed on a chair, easy chair. Okay. And what was the posture of Harry's? He was keeping his legs on the table. Okay, cross leg, yes. So Jerome was liking his body language or not? Not. Yes, he was feeling so weird. He did not like it at all. So we will continue this chapter tomorrow. Thank you.